Hello friends, today we will solve numerical on consolidation chapter. Calculate the final settlement of the clay layer shown in figure due to an increase of pressure of 30 kN per meter square at mid height of the layer. Also calculate the settlement when the water table rises to the ground surface. This is the figure given in the question. This question was asked in May 2015 for 10 marks in Mumbai University exam. Now see here, there are two cases, okay, without water table and with water table, okay. So first we will consider without water table. This is the ground level. Below the ground level there is a sand layer for 5 meter, and after 5 meter there is a 2.5 meter clay thickness is there. Gamma is given for sand and clay. First we will see first case. In first case we are not considering the water table, okay. So delta is given, delta sigma is given to us, that is increase in pressure is 30 kN per meter square. First we will write down the given data. Delta sigma is given to us, CC is given to us 0.35, void ratio is given to us 1.5. now calculate sigma 0. Sigma 0 is the effective pressure, okay, that is the pressure till the center of the clay layer, okay. Now sigma 0 is equal to z into gamma, so z is the depth and gamma is the unit weight of the soil, okay. Now in first layer the z is 5 meter and gamma is 19, so 19 plus 19 into 5. After this layer, now in second clay layer gamma is 17 and the mid of the clay is 2.5 by 2, okay, so 1.25, 17 into 1.25, because we always calculate the pressure at the center of the clay layer, that's why 2.5 divided by 2, that is 1.25. so sigma 0 is 116.25 kN per meter square. We know that the settlement of foundation, settlement of the clay layer is delta H is equal to H0 into CC upon 1 plus E log 10 sigma 0 plus delta sigma by sigma 0. So height of the clay layer is 2.5 into CC is already given to us 0.35. So 0.35 plus 1 plus E is 1.5 log of 10 sigma 0, just we have calculated 116.25. Delta sigma is already given to us 30. With the help of this formula we have calculated the settlement is 0.035 meter, that means 35 mm, okay. This is the first case. Here we have not considered the water table. Now water table rise to the ground level. Now we have to consider the water table rise to the ground level, then what will happen. Now case number 2, when water table rise to the ground level, then only sigma 0 will change. Now here we have to consider the submerged unit weight, okay. So gamma submerged is equal to gamma sat minus gamma w, we know that. So submerged is 19, okay. So here 19 minus 9.81. why 9.81? unit weight of water is 9.81 or 10. So because of the water table rise to the ground level, we have to consider this gamma is gamma submerged. Now gamma submerged is equal to gamma sat minus gamma w, so this water is gamma, this gamma is gamma sat, okay. So submerged is equal to gamma sat minus 9.81 into depth of the sand layer is 5 meter, so 5 plus 17, this was the 17 minus 9.81 into 1.25, because we have to consider pressure till the center of the clay layer, so 1.25. so here sigma 0 is equal to 54.93 kN per meter cube, okay. Again same formula you have to use it. Again H0 is the depth of the clay layer is 2.5. always take care depth of the clay layer, not the entire depth of the soil profile. Only we have to consider the depth of the or height of the clay layer here. So 2.5 into CC is 0.35, 1 upon E is 1.5 log of 10. Now sigma 0 we have calculated here 54.93 plus delta sigma is already given to us, this is increase in pressure is 30, 54.93 sigma 0. And here the settlement is 0.067 meter, that means 67 meter. Here we can clearly see that if water table increases, the settlement also increases. Here water here is no water table, so settlement is 35 mm. Now here water table is till the ground level, so settlement is 67 mm. So is here we can conclude that if water table is increased to the ground level, settlement is also increases. Thank you. If you like this lesson, give the thumbs up by hitting the like button. If you new to my channel, click that subscribe button and that little bell icon next to it to get my latest lesson right here on YouTube. Happy learning. Now we will see you in another lesson.